Okay, guys, thank you so much for checking back on Grazio Arts. Usually I do art and crafts and cosplay. From time to time, I do like to go ahead and do product reviews, and even though I might be a week late, I just got the new iPhone SE, and I want to go ahead and give my complete review and opinion on this phone since I just got it in the mail today. I did order it April 17th. It did ship out on the 24th and came all the way from China. And I'm really excited. Let's go ahead and do the unboxing. Okay, so here's a box, and like always, Apple does a beautiful job in the presentation. This is the 256 gigabyte version, product red Apple iPhone. So I was really excited to do this because I was in need of an update. I was still using the iPhone SE from 2016. And I was pretty happy with it, but the battery has started to wear down. So you get the Design by Apple products red, their partnership program. Welcome to iPhone. Gives you the basic information, how to turn it on, how to put it to sleep. It's a single sheet. And I wasn't a fan of Face ID, so that's why I never updated. Here is the always useful paperclip. Safety stickers, of course. And the phone itself, here it is. As I was saying, I was never a fan of Apple Face ID. I've always been a fan of Apple, but never a fan of Face ID. I wasn't really comfortable with it. And I always preferred the little home button here and the fingerprint ID. I like that. This feels really, really nice. It's hefty. Compared to the 2016 Apple iPhone, which is what I'm recording on right now. This feels nice. Has a nice weight to it. So I'm gonna go ahead and take this off. I love that. I love doing that. And Apple really knows how to presents its product. So here I'm looking at an aluminum frame, the black center, and it's not a polished aluminum, it's the matte aluminum, brushed aluminum. There it is, a red brushed aluminum. And there is a close-up of the camera. The logo that's now at the center in product red. And supposedly, I guess we're getting two speakers here on the bottom. And I guess there's another speaker here. This feels really nice. And I'm really glad that they put the Touch ID because I like that. I'm used to it. And it's so iconic. You know, you can't have an iPhone without the Touch ID. I think, despite what everybody says that it's old, it's youthful, you know. And now that everybody's covering their face with the coronavirus and you need to wear a mask, you know, Face ID isn't practical, but the Touch ID, I always liked that. And in my opinion, practicality and usability doesn't have a year, you know, it's always in style and it's always useful. It kind of hurt me when they, got rid of iTunes. I always thought that was really useful, but they got rid of it. and the Touch ID is back. So I really, really like that, and I really appreciate it. Good technology is good no matter what year it is. So just because something's new or just invented doesn't make it better. And I've learned that with technology and computers. There are some things that even though they're like from 10 years ago, I prefer them. You know, they were useful. So I always prefer usability and practicability over fashion and style. So let's go ahead and turn this baby on. I'm excited because I really want to go ahead and update. So that is the how to get into the chip. So welcome to iPhone. Side button, Touch ID, ring switch. So all that's pretty much the same. What I do miss is the earphone plug. I do miss the earphone jack. I don't feel that they should have gotten rid of that, because even now, to this day, there are going to be instances where we're going to need that. And I always like to have a mix of technology, like on my iPhone 2016. But, you know, I do have AirPods, so that's not going to be an issue. You know, and I like to be wireless, but just in case of emergencies, I would have preferred that they keep the earphone jack there, but that's okay. I'm willing to let that go. Okay, so if you're used to iPhone, you're pretty much aware of what these buttons do. We have the ringtone switch. This silences the entire phone. When you switch it this way, switch it that way, you activate the sounds. This is the volume up and down button. And when you're using the camera, those have other functions as well. And here is the power button. And we're going to turn it on for the first time right now. Now, when it comes to the box, we do have the new earplugs, which have the lightning connector, which connect down here. We have our charging cable. And we have, I believe, the 5-watt charger, which comes in every iPhone. That's pretty standard. Okay, so now we are turning it on. It's giving us the greeting in all the languages. So now we just press home to open. And this Touch ID, I have to say, if you're used to the other Touch ID that was like kind of deep, there was a deepness to it, this one is not deep. This one's very, very like on the surface. Okay, you can barely even feel it. Okay, that's a difference I'm noticing. Compared to the old iPhone SE, this is very on the surface. It's like very minimal. See, you can barely see the Touch ID. It's not as deep as it used to be, the home button. So it's very on the surface. So it does feel more sleek, much more advanced. Very minimal. Select your country, United States. Quick start. Bring your current iPhone or iPad near this iPhone to sign in and set up. If your other iPhone or iPad doesn't show options for setting up this phone, make sure it's running iOS or later and has Bluetooth turned on. You can also set up iPhone manually. I'm going to go ahead and do it manually just for the purpose of the video. Choose a network. All right, let me go ahead and choose that. So I've chosen my network, I input my password, I'm connected to Wi-Fi. A good thing here is that the battery is almost fully charged. That was nice. I like that. Obviously, I haven't put in the service chip, so it says no service. Right now, the data and privacy, we're just going to continue. Touch ID. I want to go ahead and set that up now. Continue. Place your finger. I'm going to go with this one. So what you do here that you lift it and you make sure you get all the crevices of your finger. And I always make sure he gets everything. Okay, so I'm gonna, now it's asking me for a password. Okay, so now I enter my passcode. Surprising new thing right here. It's asking me for a 6-digit passcode instead of the usual 4. On my iPhone 2016, I only had a 4-digit passcode. This one's asking me for 6 digits. So that's new. So now we're going to go ahead and restore from an old phone. Or we can restore from the iCloud backup. Transfer directly from an iPhone, which I've never seen that before. That's new to me. Move data from an Android. That's new to me as well. I haven't seen that before. They've never offered that option before. That's impressive. So just to be on the safe side, I'm going to go ahead and restore from a Mac or PC because that's what I'm used to. So I'm going to go ahead and show you guys how that's done. Okay, so here I am. I'm on my Mac Mini. And even though now it looks like the phone is more modern and we can update from phone to phone, which that's kind of new to me. I'm kind of impressed that they've done that. I'm going to keep it simple. And I'm going to go ahead and use the older method that I'm used to, which was iTunes. But obviously iTunes no longer exists. But we can go ahead and use a different program here. If you're used to iTunes and you know that iTunes is no longer around, what we're going to do is we're going to click on the Finder. Okay. So you just click on Open Finder and you click on your phone. Okay, so that's my old phone. And this is the new iPhone. Go ahead and trust. It's already at 87% capacity. And now it's saying, welcome to your new iPhone. Would you like to set up this iPhone as a new iPhone or restore your information from a previous backup? And it's going to give you the option set up as new device or restore from this backup. And you're going to have the option to choose which phone you want to back up from. Before filming this video, I backed up my old iPhone. So that's what I'm going to do. And continue. Okay, then it's going to say iPod software license agreement. You just scroll through that, read it, and then agree to the terms. Save. Come over here and continue. Actually, that's my old iPhone. Okay, now on my phone, it's giving me this. Connect Mac over to a PC with iTunes. Okay, so it looks like it's not going to allow me to do that using the Finder. It really wants to use iTunes, and I thought iTunes didn't exist. Okay, so let's try the other option. So let's go into the future and transfer directly from iPhone. Quick start. It says, bring your current iPhone or iPad near this iPhone to sign in and set up. If your iPhone or iPad doesn't show options for setting up this iPhone, make sure it's running iOS or later and has Bluetooth turned on. You can also set up this iPhone manually. Okay. So let's go ahead and do that. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to stop recording. But what I can record, I will record. Give me one second. Okay, guys, so what I ended up doing, since it wasn't letting me use the, what do you call it? The Finder window to go ahead and update from my computer, because the computer wanted to use iTunes, and well, iTunes does not exist. I decided to go ahead and use the transfer from phone to phone option. And I have to say, I was very, very impressed. You don't even need a computer to go ahead and do that. I've never seen that before. I don't know how current you guys are, but I haven't updated my phone since 2016, and even then, I did not see the option to update from one iPhone to another. So what happened was, when I updated the phone, I selected update from another phone here on the screen when it gave me the option. And what happened was, both of your phones, my old phone and this phone, connected to my Wi-Fi network. You do need a Wi-Fi network and Bluetooth turned on. And through those two Wi-Fi and the Bluetooth, information traveled wirelessly from my old phone over to my new phone. So if you don't have a computer, if you don't have iTunes, you don't have to worry about it, because iTunes has got you covered. To me, that is very impressive. I was just very impressed with that. I was very impressed with that, and you can update from the iCloud, you can update from the phone, from your old phone, you can update from the computer as long as you have iTunes. You can also update from an Android phone. And to me, that's just really impressive. Apple should have done that a long time ago, but I think it's so impressive that they have been able to incorporate and give you the options no matter where you're coming from. If you're coming from the Android market, if you're coming from an old iPhone that you haven't updated in a long time, Apple really put thought into this, into their product, and they got you covered no matter what. So that's just really, really impressed me, and I really, really like that. One of the first changes, or one of the first changes that I noticed here on this phone, is that Apple sensor, the touch sensor, is a little different from what I'm used to on the 2016 model. Like I said before, it's very shallow. You can barely tell that it's there. And when you click it, to me, it feels like the entire surface is clicking downward into the aluminum case. But that's not true, because if I push here, you know, it's pretty solid, it doesn't move. But if I push here, you hear a click. And I think that's the way it's supposed to be, but it gives me a sensation that I've never felt before with the 2016 iPhone SE, where when I click the button, I actually feel like I'm clicking the fingerprint sensor, and that it's being activated. On this one, I feel like it feels that way. I know it's not, that's not what's going on, but just how it feels. It feels like this entire portion is clicking down. Similar to my MacBook Pro. If you have a MacBook Pro and you have a mouse on the MacBook Pro and you click when you want to select something, that's how it feels. Very, very similar to that. So I'm a big fan of the fingerprint sensor, of the home button. But this one feels a little weird to me. I'm sure I'll get used to it. But that's the only off thing that feels different to me. Now, what I'm going to do, if you notice, I don't have any service yet, because I still need to transfer my data card over to this phone, and we'll go ahead and do that now. Okay, so what I did now was I went ahead and used the paperclip that was included in the packaging of the new phone, and it's really included in every iPhone you buy, and I always keep them because they're very useful. And what I did was that I went into my old phone and I stuck it in here, and out popped out the SIM card. And I opened up this one and I put it in here. And I gotta say, another good prop to Apple is that no matter what generation of iPhone you have, the SIM card is always the same size. And I gotta give them props for that, because when you buy a new phone, you always have to deal with the hassle of getting a new SIM card, because the SIM card on the phone may be a different size. But I've had three iPhones in my history. I've had three different iPhones, and this one being a different size from my previous iPhone. The SIM card and the tray is exactly the same size. So I really appreciate them doing that, because I don't have to go get another SIM card and reactivate that SIM card and put it on the new device. All I had to do was get my old phone, take out the old SIM card, and stick it into my new phone, and I automatically now have service. Another thing I want to point out, because I was going through my phone here and I was checking out the music before, and I'm talking about iPhones from 2016 back. Something that really frustrated me with Apple was that in those days you could only transfer music that you had purchased through iTunes. I'm sorry. So the music that you purchased through iTunes, that is the only music it would let you transfer easily from your computer to your phone. And this is just in regards when you're updating your phone. All the CDs, for example, if I had bought a CD at a store and I ripped the music from that CD and saved it into iTunes and put it on my phone, that music would not transfer over to my new phone. And that music was Apple would discard it and just leave it there. It wouldn't consider it. And it would just transfer the music that I had purchased on iTunes. And I always thought that was very unfair and very troublesome, because I had to go back manually and input that music again to the new phone, which it was already converted to digital anyway, so it was a minor inconvenience, but it was an inconvenience because I had to double check to make sure all my music was on my phone. And the great thing that happened now that left me completely impressed is that not only did all my information, my contact information, all my texts, all my calls, but all my music, even the music that I ripped from a CD, for example, Paramore, I bought the CD and I saved it to iTunes and I put it on my phone. I did not buy it off of iTunes, but I bought the CD. And if you notice, here it is. It's right there. And I did not have to manually input it in. This time, Apple, I don't know how many people complained. I don't know, but it took them years. Okay, I'm talking decades here. Here's another one, Nirvana. I bought this CD and I had to save it in iTunes. Had I done this update 4 or 5 years ago, iTunes would have ignored this CD and just transferred over the music that I bought from iTunes and completely ignoring all of my CDs, completely ignoring that. And if you're used to iTunes and you're familiar with iPhones, you know what I'm talking about. You know that when you updated to a new phone, Apple would not let you transfer over your CD music saved on your phone over to a new phone. You would have to, you know, it would just transfer over the music from iTunes that you bought on iTunes, and then you would have to go in later and drop in the CDs that you saved on your computer. Now, even this Marilyn Manson CD, lest we forget, one of my favorite CDs, I bought that on CD. Well, actually, my sister gave me that CD as a Christmas birthday present. And I saved it on iTunes, and here it is. I did not have to go into the computer and save it again. It's right there. And again, I'm going to give Apple props for doing that, because it took them a long damn time to understand that, you know, when we transfer our information, we want to transfer everything in one step. You know, I don't want to go back and see what's missing. And in my other incarnations of iPhones, especially with iTunes, it wouldn't do that. It would just transfer music over from iTunes that you bought on iTunes, and it would ignore everything else. And I would have to go check what was missing and then put all that missing stuff, all that missing music back into the phone. And it was a real hassle, and it was a real bummer too, because I could never trust that Apple would save all of my information. So now it's completely saved and I'm completely blown away. That has never happened to me before, and before it wasn't like that. And I just gotta give them props. The setup, super simple, 10 out of 10. The information that carried over, 10 out of 10. All my music is right there. CDs, whether it be a CD that I saved or a music that I bought in iTunes. I'm sorry, music that I bought in Apple Music. It's there. It did not discriminate. So, Apple, you get a 10 out of 10 out of there. And another thing is the sounds. I'm just going to play a little short segment, because I don't want to get a copyright. But this is the Taylor Swift Lover album. And I just want you guys to listen to the sound. So I'm just going to play a few seconds of music. How many days did I spend thinking about how you did me wrong, wrong, wrong? Lived in the shade you were through. Okay. I was blown away by the sound from this phone. Okay, typically, whether it be an Android phone or an iPhone, sound only came from the bottom, and you can tell the sound quality wasn't all that great. But even on an iPhone, it was better than an Android, and I could still listen to music just from the phone or connected via my AirPods or connected via Bluetooth to a stereo or in case the stereo that I wanted to use didn't have Bluetooth, I could still use the audio jack, plug in through the aux, and listen to my music that way. This one, this sound that you just heard, blew me away. It is incredible because you are getting a surround sound system in a phone. And that's awesome. These few seconds of music that we just heard, I felt like I was listening to an actual stereo. That's the quality of the sound that's coming out of this phone. I feel that if I go to YouTube or if I record a movie on this phone, I'm going to be able to hear it in surround sound. That's really what it sounds like. The sound is crisp, and you're getting two feeds. So you're getting the left feed and you're getting the right feed. In this music, when she snapped, or you heard a snap, that was coming from up here. And the rest of the music was coming from down here. And you really get that surround sound quality. And that's very impressive. Again, I'm going to give Apple 10 out of 10 for the sound system. So far, I'm incredibly impressed. The only thing that's putting me down, and it's not even that big of a deal, is how this feels. The Apple finger sensor. It feels a little weird. I'm used to the old finger sensor. So if you feel like this is an old technology, it might be, because we're all used to the home button, but it has been updated because it is sleeker. It's more minimalistic, and the sensation is a lot different. It's nothing compared to the original iPhone SE from 2016. So there is an update. I don't like how it feels, because it does feel, like I said, like you're pushing against the entire bottom half, and the entire bottom half is going down. That's how it feels. But that's not actually what's going on. This, if you push down here or push down here, it's pretty solid. So in terms of setup, I'm very impressed. Sound quality is very impressed. And the thing that's most impressive, and that Apple finally was able to fix and able to do for us, was transferring all of our information, including the music. And it did not discriminate in transferring music that I saved from a CD. In my past experience, you know, I would have to do that manually. It would just ignore all the music that was on my CDs, on my computer. So music from a CD, it would just completely ignore it, and it would just transfer iTunes over. This time, all my music is there. Nothing's missing. Right here I have Diana Ross. Diana Ross, that's a CD that I bought, and it's right there. I don't even have to. I'm still going to go ahead and double check just to make sure everything is there. Okay, so like for example, this one didn't download. So it's on my phone, but for some reason I have to re-download it onto my phone and have it saved, because right now it's on the cloud. And I hate that. I always prefer to have everything stored on my phone. Okay. So I'm going to have to go and just make sure everything is saved. And nothing is in the cloud. Because, see, downloaded. And that's a little disappointing. Because for some reason, even though I have downloaded every single album I have bought from iTunes or from Apple Music, and I save it to my phone, there are instances where it'll have that cloud, and it'll say that I need to download it, but I remember downloading it. So I don't know what's going on there, where Apple or this program will delete it from your phone. Because I know I didn't delete it. So that's still something that's kind of a little fishy to me. Sheryl Crow, that's a CD I bought. It's still here. So for the most part, This is amazing. Not so amazing is that there's still music that I remember downloading and saved to my phone that's not there. I have to see, look, there it goes. Spider-Man. It's asking me to download it because it's not saved. Well, one song is not saved. And I don't know why that happens. Everything should be saved. I remember saving everything. So I'm going to have to double check and make sure everything is here, but I'm still impressed. I'm still very, very impressed. I like this. Yes, I have NSYNC here. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and just double check that and make sure all my music is there. But for the most part, setup, super easy. Transferring all my info, super easy. The sound quality is super easy. I'm gonna go ahead and update you guys after a week just to let you know what I think about this phone and the usability. And give you the update as to what I think after a week of use. Thank you so much for checking back on Grozio Art. And if you have time, go ahead and check out my other videos. I do cosplay, art stuff, and comedy skits. And hopefully there will be more coming. Thank you for choosing Grozio Art on YouTube. And if you have the time to sign up, I'd really appreciate it. Share this video, like, and I will see you guys next time.